During my PhD, that's when I started working seriously on partial differential equations. The area, a specific area in partial differential equations that I worked on was the theory of homogenization. So this has very many applications in, for example, petroleum engineering, okay, and in very real life situations. So technically speaking, homogenization is a theory where one studies partial differential equations with highly oscillating coefficients. So this theory tries to replace the PDE with the partial differential equation with highly oscillating coefficient by a PDE which has constant coefficients, for example. So in that I worked on convection diffusion equations for 3 years for my PhD. Partial differential equations, if you try to model any real life situation, for example a flow of fluid or the atmosphere, how it behaves, the atmosphere dynamics, even the traffic flow, so you end up writing certain equations and they all tend to be partial differential equations because each of the unknowns, okay, the things which we are interested in, they depend on very many variables, so that's why it's a partial differential equation rather than an ordinary differential equation. So when somebody writes down a partial differential equation, it comes out of modeling. There are certain assumptions made in order to arrive at that model. So it's an approximation to a real life problem in some sense. But in order to gain any insight into what you have modeled, your partial differential equation needs to be well posed. That means it should not be a nonsense equation. There should be solutions to that problem. It should not be something which is unsolvable. And also, it should have some reasonable properties. For example, which you can see in the real life scenarios which you want to model. So those are the topics which people are interested in. Anybody who is working in partial differential equation, they are mainly concerned about certain class of partial differential equations and they study questions of existence, uniqueness of solutions to such problems. Then there are qualitative properties which you can derive out of those equations, but that comes later. In certain situations, however, people do the properties of the solutions first because proving that a solution exists to a particular equation is hard in some problems. For example, there is an equation called Navier-Stokes equation, which is part of a 7 Millennium Prize problems. So people don't know whether solutions are unique to that problem. So depending on what kind of equation you have chosen, you can either do the existence uniqueness theory or study the qualitative properties. So this is broadly speaking what people, mathematicians working on partial differential equations. If you ask me, I am biased because I did my master's there. If one wishes to study partial differential equations, then they need to go to France and especially Paris, the capital city, for at least 6 months as a mathematician, not for tourism. Then you get to see the real work that goes on in the area of partial differential equations. Most of the theory of partial differential equations was developed in France. So there is this big culture and there are very many mathematicians who work in this area. And they have also started a wide variety of master's programs. Dedicated to partial differential equations in some sense. So I happened to do a master's program which was one among these master's programs. So it was a good one. And now if an Indian student wants to go to France and pursue a master's. For example, the master's program which I did was a joint master's program between University of Paris 6 and Ecole Polytechnique. So there you need to have certain basic knowledge before you understand the courses there. So it may not be a bad idea to actually do a master's in India and then go for the second year master's program. You can actually join the second years of master's program in France. There is no need to do full 2 years. You can join the second year and understand the analysis courses properly. To begin with, you need to know real analysis and complex analysis. Then master functional analysis. Then only you'll be able to understand the courses, because they're all very fast paced. The semesters are very short. So if you lag behind, you lose the touch, and also the exams will be fast approaching. So what I would suggest is to, at least out of your own interest, you need to study more of analysis courses if you are interested in PDs. Then you can apply for these things. Of course, you need to get selected for these programs. It's not open for everybody. So, however, they do tend to choose many students. They want to fill their universities. So they, and also they encourage foreign applicants. So if you have done well in your bachelor's degree anywhere in India, so you should be able to get. But how, of course, it's going to depend on who is going to write your reference letters. So that is one issue, but there is nothing wrong in trying. You can always make the application. The universities in Paris which offer PDE related master's program are University of Paris 6, University of Paris 7, then there is University of Paris Sud, which is in Orsay, then there is Ecole Polytechnique and Ecole Normale Supérieure. So these are some of the universities which offer master's program in PDEs. Yeah, so they are very well taught and they are very well organized. If I recall properly, during my master's program, there were around 25 to 30 PDE related courses which were taught in 1 year, and you get to choose, and you can choose courses and learn more and more. So depending on whether you want to do more theoretical side of partial differential equations or the numerical simulations part of numerical analysis of partial differential equations is also very well sought out field these days. So their program tends to like concentrate on both of these areas. So that is one of the things. Yeah, so Paris is the region if you want to study. So yeah, I would strongly suggest that they have to study more of analysis. If they mention that they have studied more of analysis, so their application might have some weightage. Okay, so because one usually makes this application when they are in their final year of BSc. So their results are not out, and usually those universities are deciding upon what you write upon yourself. So that should be fine. Of course, if you give false impression on your application and you have not studied any analysis, and by some luck you get in the program, then you reach there, you would face a lot of hurdles. It would be impossible to finish the master's without the prerequisites, which is functional analysis. So read more of analysis texts. Okay, Kesavan's book is yeah, so when I went there, my master's program was in French, so I had to learn the language. Now, apparently, they have decided to give at least part of the programs in English. So, part of the courses, I mean. So, given a master's program, you will have certain courses which are taught in English. So, you can give exams for those courses. And if you wish to learn more of the mathematics, you can attend the French language, the courses which are taught in French, and you need not write the exam for them, but it depends. If you know English language, it's not too difficult to learn French, so you can learn the language. And, being there will force you to pick up certain basic French. And you should never, going from India, there you might be tempted to just, you know, form this cluster of Indian students and not speak to any other foreign national. That's not such a good idea. It's always good to have some kind of security among your nationals, but in order to improve your language and learn a bit about their culture, you need to mingle with other students. And now regarding funding, I got the Île-de-France scholarship. That's master's scholarship. That means that's only given for master's courses. And also it's only open for international students. Okay? So Indian students have a better opportunity to getting this. I believe they give about 200 master's the scholarships every year. So if you have a reasonable application from a reasonable university in India, it gets recognition. I wouldn't say that it gets accepted, but they would look into your application. So that's one. Then there are Eiffel scholarships. They are very prestigious and it's open for everybody. In some sense, Île-de-France scholarships are given out for third world students going out from third world countries. So we get the chance. Eiffel scholarships, they are open for everybody. And they are very prestigious and they are not in the hundreds. They might give out maybe within, it's in single digits, the number of scholarships they give out. So, but it's not a bad idea to try them out, because once you write an application for a single scholarship, you need to slightly modify here and there and just send it out for another one. So try your luck. You can apply for that. The Eiffel scholarship is second one. Then there are Erasmus Mundus programs. Those are the scholarships which are given for particular programs, particular master's program. For example, if you are doing any of these PD related courses in Paris, I don't think it's part of the Erasmus Mundus. But you can try out if Erasmus Mundus has any master's program anywhere in Europe which has PDs, then you can apply for that. Of course, each of these universities, they have their own scholarships. And they are open, there are a bunch of them which are set aside for international students. So Ecole Normale Supérieure has one, Ecole Polytechnique has one. I wouldn't think that Paris 6 has something which is separate for foreign nationals, but you can go in the pool with all other French nationals and just try your luck. They usually tend to give, if you request them, make an application or something, they tend to give certain reduction in the fees, the tuition fee. So you pay little, and in France it's not expensive, the tuition part of your education, it's not expensive. If one fails to get a scholarship, then it might be a bit hard to support themselves, because you need to get a housing. The government helps you to pay your rent and all. A part of it they pay, 30-40%. But then you may have to, I know of certain examples where they have actually funded their master's program in France. So it is doable, then you may have to take out some loans, okay? So yeah. These are some of the scholarships. But this is the period, okay? January, I would say December till February. You keep a lookout, you know, just know which are the websites where these things are announced, the scholarships, and how to apply for these programs. Okay? So then, between December and February, don't lose the opportunities. keep a lookout for when are the deadlines and apply well in advance. And you need to speak to your lecturers in undergrad. They would know which course would suit you, for example, depending on what your interests are. Okay? So that should be all right. I hope this helps.